same type of page we found at Cauldron Lake.
Nightingale hunted Saga. Didn't see her. The Taken could not see into bright light. Light hurt them, made them vulnerable. Nightingale had no heart, but here he was, killing.
Someone's created a fucked up fantasy about us.
Hey, hold on. We found these kinds of pages. I didn't think they were relevant to this case. I have them right here.
My gun's out in the hall. Gotta get it back. Go! The room. I need to find it. Need to get my gun. But he still got up. The page predicted all of it. It helped me fight him.
He just disappeared? What the hell is going on here?
We need to figure that out if we're gonna do anything about it. Somehow we need to make sense of this. There is no rational explanation to what we just saw.
I'd love to blame this on mass hallucination caused by inhaling volcanic gas, but we both know that's bullshit. This was supernatural.
Well, I'm glad you were the one to say it. Now we can figure out a way forward. The victim of a ritualistic murder turns into a monster. Is there a connection?
Looks to me like the cult of the tree is performing rituals to create monsters.
Maybe. We need to start with learning this cult's goal, their purpose. Right before things got crazy, Sheriff Breaker just vanished.
Maybe the sheriff knew more than he was letting on.
He seemed anxious, like he dreaded what was coming. One more mystery.
There's one of the pages on the floor. The heart is gone too. Did the fucker take it with him?
Saga was back at Cauldron Lake. Saga had to pursue Nightingale into the overlap. Finding a way in would be difficult. A ritual. Saga would learn how. Stop the monster.
A dead man turned into a monster. Light as a way to fight him. Pages predicting the future. There's no rational explanation. This is the case we must solve. We're dealing with an organized group of killers, not a lone serial killer.
They were tearing into the naked guy with knives.
The cult of the tree is behind these murders. This case just became much more complicated. I'll need to start a new file. But it's my first cult case. Exciting. I need to know more about the cult of the tree if I'm going to shut them down. That's not right.
We heard gunshots. Y'all okay?
Did you get spooked by the bodies?
Sheriff Breaker disappeared. Nightingale turned into some sort of a monster, and there are offices down. You two handle things here. We need to get back to Cauldron Lake immediately.
Fuck me. That's terrible. We'll do what we can, man.
But that's crazy, right, Thornton? Nightingale's heart was missing. How could he do anything? He's dead.
Yeah, right. Well, that's all crazy talk. Monsters aren't real, and what do you mean the sheriff disappeared? Like poof? He's gone like magic? Magic's not real.
No, Thornton. Monsters aren't real, and magic's definitely not real.
I knew that.
They're a fine pair.
My client has been held here long enough. Are you gonna
Nightingale and his cult are dangerous. We need to be prepared in case things escalate more than they already have. Can you call it in, KC?
A smart choice, Anderson. Yeah, Agent Casey here. Yeah. We need backup. The Bright Falls case. Whoever you can spare. ASAP. Think we'll actually find Nightingale at the lake?
The pages haven't been wrong yet.
We can't assume the person writing these pages isn't playing us.
I agree. But it's our best lead.
Mercetto won't roll over on the issues.
Look around. Meet you back at the car.
See you in a bit. Did you check out the town, Anderson?
Just getting my bearings. Ready to go?
Waiting on you.
Rinse and repeat. Clock out, get a beer. Or maybe three.
I need to come clean, Anderson. I know why Nightingale was here 13 years ago. He was chasing a writer, Alan Wake.
Tammy mentioned him. She's writing a book on his disappearance.
You know the detective character from his books, Alex Casey.
Yeah, I've heard the jokes at the office. Cold Case Casey. Murder Case Casey. Sorry.
Ha ha. The same name, similar job. It's the first thing anyone thinks of. It annoyed me, but that was it. Then, 10 years ago, I started getting strange letters in the mail. Fragments of prose describing murders. You've heard the stories about what happened in New York. Some of it, at least. Bodies started to pile up. It was a murder cult. Turns out the fragments sent to me were from the crime books of Alan Wake. The cult was copycatting the murders from the books. In their heads, they were performing a ritual to bring Wake back. Their imagined prophet. After that case, I started looking into Wake's disappearance on the side.
And you thought this case might be connected to him? His name does keep popping up.
I just wanted you to have all the facts.
Next time, give them to me before we find ourselves in the middle of a horror story.
Thank you.
The page says Nightingale's in something called an overlap. Need to figure out exactly what that means.
I'm happy I'm not in charge of this mess.
Thanks. Let's start looking for Nightingale where he was killed. The writer of these pages knows what will happen. Because they're behind this, or because they can see what's coming. Impossible things are happening here. A world operating on different rules. I need to understand this strange logic. To see the clues. To solve the case.
Hey, hello there. How are you folks doing?
Those restricted areas.
Hello.
Don't do it.
Saga Anderson. Are you two supposed to be here?
I'm Ilmo Koskela. Fantastic to meet you. And yes, Stephen here hired me to show him through the woods. He's in town on important government business. Fixing this impressive piece of hardware.
I work for the FBC, ma'am. I'm authorized to be here.
And I bet you two are here about that murder. Nasty stuff. How's it going?
How did you hear about the murder, Ilmo? Do you know anything that could help us?
People tend to tell me things. The Koskela brothers are kind of a household name around here. Speaking of, if you're looking for some fun, stop by Watery. Just down the road from Bright Falls, there's our Coffee World amusement park. There's Sauna da Vista. And we offer a variety of guided tours, hunting, fishing, hiking, whatever strikes your fancy. You name it, we probably got it.
What is this thing?
It's just a monitoring station, ma'am. The Federal Bureau of Control checks volcanic activity and air toxicity levels. No need to worry, though. It's mostly for research purposes.
That's one gorgeous weather saga. Looks Nordic. I bet a family member made it.
My mother made this sweater for me. How do you know?
I knew it. My mom used to knit those sweaters for me and my brother. Watery, my hometown, was founded by Finnish immigrants. So between your name and the sweater, I figured your family might be from Finland too. Suomi, Finland. Pulla, Karjalan piirakka.
Close. My mom's family is from Sweden originally. I don't know much about them beyond that. The sweater is just something to remember her by. Stephen, we're investigating a murder that occurred nearby. What can you tell me about your bureau?
Nothing that isn't classified, I'm afraid. But I don't know anything about a murder. Operations here are run by a different department. I'm just here to make some repairs. The wiring on this thing frays every couple months.
Yep, that's the raccoons. They grow real big here with teeth like you wouldn't believe. Can gnaw right through a garbage can.
Okay, we're done for now. Let's get to the murder site, Casey. A lot of things about this case keep bothering me. But one thing feels really off. Breaker's disappearance. I don't get the feeling Nightingale was responsible.
He was about to give you more of those pages. Something didn't want us to have them? Or was protecting him from Nightingale? Spontaneous combustion? I don't know. Not the kind of disappearance we normally solve. Our crime scene's drowning. I never minded rain. Feels like home.
No sign of Nightingale. But the page did place him at Cauldron Lake, in an overlap. So how do we follow him there?
Maybe something around here will tell us.
We've seen this symbol before.
Good eye.
After we find Nightingale, what then? I've never arrested a monster.
I've watched you arrest plenty of monsters, Anderson.
You know what I mean. Monsters. Light worked against him at the morgue. That might be the only way to stop him from hurting anyone else. Monsters? Overlaps? Rituals? What do you make of all of this?
The killers are usually the ones performing the ritual, not the detective. Acting out their sick fantasy. They may be trying to get you involved, forcing you into their twisted world.
But with dead men coming alive, the word ritual starts to have more weight behind it. We need to look around, learn what this ritual is. Bare feet. Nightingale. I'll see where these footprints lead. Can you comb through the crime scene one more time, KC? Just in case?
On it. If anything comes up, I'll radio you.
The tracks lead into the water. Where'd he go from here? I can feel something. A presence. Nightingale isn't far. What is that? Seems like it's reacting to the light. These aren't the same tracks that were here before. They're headed into the tree, not out of it. My flashlight burned the dark stuff away. It was covering another...
The fuse was in place. Saga stepped into the witch's hut. Inside, a bright light. There were objects that stood out to Saga, as if the light had manifested them.
The witch's hut. Okay. I trust the pages to lead me to the overlap. Witch's hut.
Anderson, thought I saw something in the woods. Probably just a deer, but I'm gonna check it out.
Okay. I found another page. Following up on a lead. Keep checking in.
Roger.
The page described the hut being lit and mentioned a fuse.
fuse box is missing a fuse. I need to find one to turn on the lights. This fuse is busted. This one looks good. People should really stop littering, though. Making progress.
The image of the witch in the sign. Saga addressed the witch. The smudged line on the heart. The second part recited from memory. I brought you the heart, witch. Show me the terror. Saga pushed the heart through the hole in the sign. The fuse was in place. She found it among the junk in the forest. Saga stepped inside the witch's hut. Something rushed through her. A presence. Familiar. She couldn't quite place it. Something long forgotten. She tried to hold onto it, but it was already gone. Inside, a bright light. Saga felt safe. Like nothing could hurt her here. There were objects that stood out to Saga as if the light had manifested them. Pulled them from the darkness. A shift in reality, heavy with hidden meanings. A coffee thermos, a shoebox, a mop and a bucket, a poster on the wall, and in the cabinet, another manuscript page. Witch's ladle, towering over Saga, watching her and the witch. The image of the witch in the sign. Nightingale's heart, a cold, dead lump in her hand. Her definition of sanity had changed since she arrived in this town. But she trusted the pages. Was forced to. Saga addressed the witch. She squinted to read the first part of the ritual words. The smudged line on the heart. A second part recited from memory. The words she had read on the page. I brought you the heart, witch. Show me the terror. Saga pushed the heart through the hole.
Don't need to go over all this again. The page from the witch's hut seems to be describing some kind of ritual. To get into the overlap, I need to find Nightingale's heart, read the line imprinted on it, plus the line on the page to the witch's ladle sign, then push the heart through the hole in the sign. Nightingale's heart disappeared from the morgue. Where is it now? I need Nightingale's heart to get to the overlap. Where is it?
The cultist leaned close. He was there, but he was risen. Nightingale was there. The opposite of sunspots. Who said that?
That's not it. I don't have what I need to find Nightingale's heart. There must be more. Nightingale's heart. Where is it?
Meanwhile, they played cards in the general store. The witch had stolen his heart. Get out of my house.
Nightingale's heart is at the general store, in a fridge. I need to check the general store for the heart.
Casey, I'm headed to the general store. I think I know how to get into the overlap.
Roger that. I followed some ATV tracks in the woods and got a bit turned around.
Did you get lost?
I've only been lost once in my life, Anderson. The years I spent with my ex-wife. I'll find my way back, don't you worry about it.
The text on the heart is clearer now. Legible. I feel like I recognize this. The fridge. The heart. I knew it would be here. Like I saw it in a dream. And now I need to give the heart to the witch. Makes total sense. Sounds literary, but what does it mean?
Meanwhile, they played cards in the general store. The witch had stolen his heart. Get out of my house.
Found the heart in the fridge. Just like the page said I would.
Saga edged toward the broken door, her gun ready, flashlight aimed ahead. Nightingale said it would be here. The Cauldron Lake General Store was overgrown, left to rot. Saga thought about the Cult of the Tree. They had been here, waiting, planning a gruesome ritual murder. Meanwhile, they played cards in the general store, like it was just another late-night poker game. Saga stepped closer to the door. Had the animal broken it? There was a loud crash. Saga found herself face-to-face with a cultist, a hulking figure in a raincoat. We watch in the night, wild eyes behind a plastic deer mask.
Casey, there are cultists in the area. They're taken, like Nightingale. Watch yourself out there.
Yeah, thanks for the heads up. I'm still finding my way back.
You have the worst sense of direction.
Any city in America I can get through drunk and blindfolded. It's these damn trees.
Okay. I'm en route to Witch's Ladle. I need to perform a ritual to open the overlap. This case just keeps getting weirder, but it is exciting. Crashed on the far side of the mirror. I brought you the Heart Witch. Show me the terror.
Oh,
overlap. Are you still on your way? Casey! You read me?
Fuck. Okay, Saga. Going in solo.
Logan?
Mom, help!
Logan! Where are you?
What the fuck was that? Logan's back in Virginia. You're imagining things.
What was that? Wait. Did I get turned around? No, this is right. This place is looping. Like a nightmare. Need to find Nightingale.
Oh. He's here. Nightingale. Signal. Nightingale's badge.
Terror.
Escape. In danger. The dark presence.
Danger. Thanks. Got it. Are you okay?
No! It's my fault! It got out with my face scratched!
Sir, calm down. I'm gonna need you to take a breath.
He's changed the story. The dark presence. We must stop it before...
Easy now. First things first. What's your name?
My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've been...
Wake? Where did you come from? You've been missing for 13 years.
13.
Where did you go? All of a sudden, the radio stopped working, and then that flooding just disappeared. Crazy forest. Is this who I think it is?
Casey, say hello to Alan Wake. Mr. Wake, this is Special Agent Alex Casey. He'll escort you to our car. Casey, I'll meet you there, right after I take a look around. If the flooding's receded, there might be evidence we missed earlier.
Okay. See you there.
Alex Casey? How? Am I still... Is this the dark place? No, it can't be.
Moving on.
Saga edged toward the broken door, her gun ready, flashlight aimed ahead.
Should look around. With the flooding gone, could be further clues out there. The flooding disappeared very suddenly. I wonder if there's any connection to the overlap, to Nightingale. The cult is leaving supplies around for themselves. The cult doesn't see their victims as people.
Thank you. The reality-changing influence of the Dark Place float...
Another locked box.
Thank you.
There's something written here. A poem? Or a riddle? A little clothespin doll. Perfect weird souvenir for Logan. Reminds me of the nursery rhymes I read to Logan when she was little. Something feels different. I should look around. A charm. Cute. It'll go great on the bracelet Logan made for me. Huh. That was strange. Gotta keep an eye out for more of these rhymes. All of them. Another one of those rhymes. Rest easy, buddy.
have a weird feeling something's changed. What is this? Okay, then. Oh, shit. Another charm for my bracelet.
Reached the car, Anderson. How's it going down there?
I think I'm done here. I'll meet you at the parking lot. I've been thinking more about the Cult of the Tree. What sort of cult refers to themselves as a cult?
In my experience, they don't.
There's another lunchbox. Ugh.
There's another cult stash. There's a rhyme over here.
Thank you.
Another charm. Good thing Logan made me this bracelet. Another one of those lunch boxes. creepy dolls, mysterious rhymes. No. The FBC is definitely playing with things they don't fully understand. And that always goes well. Another Alex Casey lunchbox? Warning. Activity detected. AWE. Event in progress. Cauldron Lake. What's an AWE? Casey, what exactly does the FBC do?
After New York, when I started looking for our friend here, their name came up. I pushed them for any files they had on him, but got stonewalled. They have a reputation of showing up for weird shit. They have a presence here, and now we find our writer. How about that?
More of those kids' lunchboxes. doesn't look right. Nightingale goes missing for 13 years, shows up murdered, and then turns into a monster. I need bolt cutters. I'm not done here yet.
This can't be the right way.
You ready to go?
Mr. Wake, we're taking you back to our field office in Bright Falls. You can freshen up there, and then we'll talk properly.
Hey, Mom. Before you say anything, I'm totally fine. Don't freak out. Dad shouldn't have even texted you.
Logan? No one texted me. What's going on?
I'm totally fine. I slipped, that's all. God, it's not the end of the world.
Put your father on the phone.
Okay. Dad, it's Mom.
Don't worry, hon. Logan slipped in the shower and bumped her head. She has a slight concussion, but I'm keeping an eye on her. Lucky I heard her fall. She could have drowned.
Jesus, David. Why didn't you call?
I tried. It didn't go through. She's fine, really. But what about you? You sound stressed.
No, it's, just a weird case, that's all.
Well, if you need a hint, my years of board game victories tell me Colonel Mustard did it.
I'll keep an eye out for him. Love you, Dave.
Love you too, honey. Want to say bye to Logan?
Just tell her I love her. Bye for now.